ground.
Let's go, go,
yeah. Let's go. I told my boys, it ain't no limits.
No.
Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Detroit Lions and the Jacksonville Jaguars. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. Play action, Lawrence. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. From the shotgun, Lawrence. That's complete. Mike Strong with it. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. The Jaguars are 2-0 here to begin the season. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
11 yards there for Jacksonville, and a first down as well. ETN up the middle and down inside the 40 to about the 38. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Now this defense for the Lions, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with 3 interceptions in that game.
Hey, exit. Hey.
From the 38, Lawrence. And it's intercepted. Picked off by DJ Reed. And the Lions are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy is not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one and let him know he'll be back the very next series.
On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. Back to throw. Hammond, and the Jags get to him as down he goes. Josh Allen able to record his 5th sack of the season.
You've caught plenty of games in your career. Do you believe in momentum, man?
I do, and I think we're seeing it right here.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. The run that he's been on, how about that? 3 sacks in a game a week ago, and another one right here. Oh, he's feeling it in a big way.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted. That winds up falling incomplete.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Here comes the Lions punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a 1st and 10. They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10, right at the 50-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda, and the Lions are going to get the football here at their own 23.
Well, it doesn't take a whole lot of investigation to figure out why they're still sitting at zero on the scoreboard, because their quarterback's got to wake up and start reading defense a heck of a lot better after throwing a second interception.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how the defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. On first down, Hammond.
And that's out to the flat for Swift.
And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
On second down, Swift. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. In motion comes the tight end left. From the gun on third down, Hammond. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Josh Allen, his second sack of the night.
Partner, you know what I'm going to say before I even say it.
Yeah, you just cannot take a sack in that spot.
You're exactly right. You can't take a sack in that spot. Potentially now, a three-point swing right there.
And he's going to miss this one. That is no good. Well outside the left upright, and this will remain a scoreless game. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Now you know that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with it, but whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
On first down, Lawrence. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. That'll give him eight that time, and it'll be second in a couple. Lawrence. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
Hey, Bostra! Hey, you!
Third and two, now Lawrence. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. And the first play will be a field goal try. The wind is at his back here in the second quarter. And that's off the right upright, and it bounces away, no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Still searching for that first breakthrough, and I thought this might be it. But it's not to be, and we're still scoreless.
Ready. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. 57 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball four times. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. Trayvon Walker makes the tackle. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Well, that's the third interception for Lawrence. And the Lions are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. How big is that penalty? Wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You got to face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you, and you hurt your squad.
And he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Looking to throw. Hammond. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line. He's sacked. They'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's third down.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down.
To throw on third down. Hammond. This one caught. It's the tight end, Hockenson. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and sent him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 18-yard line.
A loss of three on a sack made by multiple defenders. So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And, partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Only a yard on the gain there, and that'll set up third and 13.
Easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
Three. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down. Now the Lions, they send out the field goal unit here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick here is good. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead.
So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get three out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they had the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock three from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. This one a little slow to get cooking. Just a 3-0 scoreline as they begin with a 1st and 10. Here's Lawrence. He'll get that underneath ETN. And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of 4. From the 29, Lawrence. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
On 3rd down, Lawrence. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. And now that brings up 4th down there, a loss of 6 yards on the sack. On 4th down, on is Logan Cook to punt. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines.
So this punt sails out of bounds across midfield. Now the question, they're going to spot it right at the 40, the 40-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Back to throw, Hammond. And he will not be able to hang on to the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. And he fields it cleanly. A 40-yard punt, give him 3 on the return, and the Jaguars go on offense, 1st down and 10. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the 1st half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge, because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
To throw again on 2nd down, Lawrence. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be crowded well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards.
Hey, Orbit. Hey, back up. Hey, Duke. Hey, Duke.
Now Lawrence on 1st down. Got an open man. It's strong.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. So the completion good for 7 there. And it'll be second down. Play action. It's Lawrence. And that'll be taken in by Strong. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. They go play action with Lawrence. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Hey, exit. Hey, counter.
It's a throw again as Lawrence. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10.
Bravo. Hey, hey, Lawrence.
Lawrence will throw. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they have little chance of winning this one.
And this is good. He's running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. Wow, I mean, it's so rare to even see one attempted from that distance, CD, let alone converted, but he came through with confidence and matches what was Tom Dempsey's 43-year NFL record at one point of 63 yards.
Yeah, I can still see that highlight of Dempsey making that kick, and nowadays we see it a little bit differently because, remember, Dempsey was a straight-on kicker. But these guys nowadays, the range keeps increasing, and they keep putting it through the posts.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Throwing to start the drive. Hammond. And that's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. First down Detroit, 16 yards on the pickup.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength, very nice route.
On first and 10, Hammond. And that'll be caught. It's St. Brown. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. Online, but off the crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second half ready to roll. 2 field goals, the combined output in half number 1. Could be first touchdown wins. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles, as we start the third quarter. Curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
Looking to throw on second down. Hammond, a hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Really good coverage all over the field that took away his intended read and almost dared him to try for his guy out of the backfield. No surprise on that one. It doesn't connect.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Operating from the gun, Hammond. He rifles one that's intercepted. And the Jaguars are going to take possession of the football. So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
I just think by the time you spend the locker room going over what you're expected to do in the second half, not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up, you find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Now that was an inspirational scramble for a first down, all the while absorbing a big-time hit. Well, we know the guys in the huddle appreciate what he's doing, but how about the guys in the press box, the luxury boxes, the guy who signs his checks, and especially the main guy with the headset on the sideline? I'm not so sure they like that so much.
He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Here's Lawrence to throw. Touchdown, Jaguars! A great play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Jags take the forced turnover on defense and convert it into 6 points. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And the lead is now 10-3. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. So the offense back out now, coming off its first interception of the game the last time out, trying to reestablish some momentum here, Charles. But they're trailing defensively. Maybe these guys smelling the blood in the water a little bit.
Yeah, I think that they probably are. But what they need to do right now is just make sure they don't force the action too much themselves. They've got them on the run a little bit. You just want to be in a position where if they make another mistake, you're there to capitalize on it and take it away from them.
To throw on second down. Hammond. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First down, Detroit, 16 yards on the pickup. And that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Tackled there by Monte Nicholson.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, Charles, just some visibly frustrated players and coaches on that sideline right now because those halftime adjustments didn't work. The turnover problems continuing here in the second half, and the defense now sitting pretty comfortably as a result of that pick six.
Hey, that's a great observation too, Brandon, because they did make adjustments at halftime. But how about this other group staying a step ahead despite whatever happened in that other locker room? No surprise they're leading, and it's appropriate that those defenders got to add to the lead directly.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And not the first time that they're coming back out off of a turnover, but the last one really hurt, Charles, with that pick six.
And it feels like the whole team's infected right now, doesn't it? It's not just been one person. It's kind of been a group effort where the mistakes have happened. Can they put that aside, kind of start over, and put together a nice drive?
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards. The offense has to love that because that was just a dump down, and then he turned something out of seemingly nothing.
And the best quarterbacks understand that dumping it down is often a good play, a better play than even what was drawn up.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
They run out of the gun with Swift. Down to about the 37.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Looking to throw, Hammond, and he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Monte Nicholson picks it, and the Jags are going to get the football here at their own 23.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him run through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
A very solid gain of 27.
That's another beautiful throw right there. It gets it to his man right in stride, and I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm, they've been sharp, they've been on it, and they pick up another first down there.
From midfield now, Lawrence. We'll get this into the hands of Strong.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence.
That's going to be caught. Touchdown. A great effort there. With 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game.
And the Jaguars get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play.
So they'll go ahead and accept the penalty.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19.
Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
A 2nd and 10 forthcoming here. Third quarter action from Jacksonville.
To throw again. Hammond, and it's incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw. Hammond. He's got this complete to Williams. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Well, your QB's been sacked four times in the game already, and they're the holding call.
And you know darn well the offensive line coach is frustrated and upset that he's been hit that many times already. He doesn't really care that they hold now. Just don't let him get hit anymore.
Throwing on third and long. Hammond. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I thought he had that one, and that was nearly a big third down conversion to give this drive some life. Instead, they're on the spot and help separate the receiver from the ball.
He'll take it a few steps in front of the 50. It's a 39-yard punt, 8 on the return. Now the Jags will have great field position to start this drive as they take over on the short side of the field. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Hey, exit. Hey, Delta. Bravo.
Now Lawrence to throw. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. A great play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jaguars will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And that'll increase their lead to 28. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And he's going to lose yardage here as they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter play. The offense on third down tonight, it's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This will be third and forever. Swift going to try up the middle. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the 3. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page, because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far. And it's cost him.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. And taken at the 46. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. They go play action now. Lawrence rolling to his right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
To throw once more on second and 10. Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Well, their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
He finds his man complete. It's Weber. Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much. Well, they're up comfortably here, Charles, but that lead certainly not dissuading them from pressing the envelope late. I mean, if anything, with these passes, it's like they're getting more aggressive to try to drive the ball downfield.
And that will certainly lend itself to some post-game questions for that coach, and maybe you and I should attend that press conference.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Jaguars are closing in on a third straight victory to start the campaign. And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look at this one. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Nice run defense presented there, and what I mean by that is discipline. Guys filling the right gaps in the right holes, no one over-pursuing, and making a very nice play.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Operating from the gun. Hammond, Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Caleb on Chason, the former first-rounder, in there to get the sack.
Part of my vocabulary isn't that great, but to me, there's only one word that fits this front seven today, and that's dominant. Four and five sacks is already rare in one game. Getting to more than six in one contest while winning by this many points, an absolutely astounding effort by every player involved.
They wind up getting 16, but even that's not quite enough. It's fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he is going to have the Lions first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. No reason not to try it there. And they do indeed convert on fourth.
No catch. No catch.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Well, this is getting ridiculous. Eight sacks now. That time multiple guys get to it. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
Throwing on first down, Hammond. Hockenson crossing the middle and bringing it in. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Fourth quarter, certainly not enough time for a comeback, but nice to see them making use of the time remaining to try and make this one a little more respectable.
Yeah, I think the ultimate goal, good execution.
And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And that'll cut the lead down to 28. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate, but we'll see what they decide to do as they come out with this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
Well, a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. Flush to his right. And he's got a man here, complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Now it's looking incredibly likely to be a 3-0 start to this season. That is obviously excellent. 2-0 is one thing. 3-0, you really have some momentum.
And now they're serving notice to the rest of the league that they're a pretty darn good football team. Confident, aggressive, attacking at all times. This looks like a team that you're going to have to deal with. And guess what? Behind closed doors, they're trying to figure out ways to get better.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
no,
again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 77 yards on the ground here for Swift. He's got a first down as well. From Swift is hit, and he coughs it up. And the Jags grab it. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. And I don't know that that fumble is going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth. It doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week, because
Maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy throughout the game.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just added their totals.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. And they will take a knee here. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
Okay, break.
And they'll indeed take a knee. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance work by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best. And I think that's what we saw for both the offense and the defense, a complete team victory.
So for the Jags, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the New York Jets come to town. Meanwhile, for Detroit, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Green Bay Packers.
Big baby slide through.